It's day 23 of Advent of Code. It's starting in just over 2 minutes. So far we have solved every single one of the problems the night of, or the next morning, as a few of them were. So I'm pretty happy with that. Could be a lot worse. This year is definitely easier, I feel like, than last year though. So, okay, here we go. That's not right. Oh, that is. Shoot. Oh, that's a test input. I'm so dumb. Also, that's wrong. Shoot, I forgot the wraparound part. I see. So three. Those are what get picked up. Those are the leftovers. Then, that's fine. And then oh, Wait. Current. Eight oh one three four six seven two five. So pick him 913. And we get 4. Four six seven 913258. Nine eight three. 836. Move 1, 2, move 3, 8, 9, 1, 3, 4, 2, 5, 4, 6, 7, 4, 6, 7, 9, 1, 3, 2, 5, 8. 1, 3, 6, 7, 9, 2, 5, 8, 4, 9, 3, 8, 7. Oh shoot. Four, three, two, one. Submit. Not terrible. Oh, yes, of course. Okay, so now I'm gonna have to be clever. So that'll work. Okay, so this should be a Q, I believe. Okay. Okay, new idea. Oh, this isn't gonna work. How is this supposed to work? So I thought this was just a queue problem. Yeah, 1 million times 10 million doesn't make any sense. So my queue implementation is wrong. How am I supposed to do this? Okay, I think this is a deck. convenient the ones here, I think. This is what happens when I use dummy variables. Create 91. Okay, so we take that, and then what we do is we pop them to the from the left, left, left. Then the destination is right there. Then we put the 3 at the end. Okay. Let me just think here. So we take the picked is this. Okay, we figure out D. Two is at zero, and then we append current. Is this fast enough? I doubt it. Well, it's faster. I don't know if it's right. That's the problem. Let's just see. This should work if I just do I think it should, that this should be the same functionality, right? Oh, I don't actually need this append. But this is concerning, I think. My leaderboard isn't updating. No idea. Literally no idea. Two, eight, nine, one, five, four, six, seven, three. Okay. I wanna steal your freedom. I don't wanna change your mind. Okay, I equals one. Okay, then two is the current. D is six. Two. Oh, that's wrong. Oh, no, we're good. D is seven. Let me actually just I'm just gonna solve it. I can try to brute force, but this is gonna take forever. Maybe it's a smart idea to try and brute force it, but I don't want maximum freedom. I don't want to take your time. Okay, wait a second. What? So destination is 7. So we pick up 8, 9, 1. Okay. Then we find the 2. It's right there. And we want to put it at the 7. So we take the 2 off, we take the 5 off. DQ 5, 4, 6, 7. Why is 7 back on here? Oh no, it's fine. That one's fine. So we put the current and then, or we put that there and then we put those there and then we have the rest of the list. Okay. And then we put at the very end, q.append x, q.append current, okay. Then, so 1 is what the issue is. So 8, 9, 1. We look for 7. Three, five, four, six. Three, five, four, six. Where did the 2 go? The 2 got pulled out. Q.pop left, okay, and then what are you gonna do? Here. If we take the current, then what we do is it's so 1, 3, 8, 9, 5, 2, 8, 9, 1, 5, 4, 6, 7, 3. Okay. Then we take 2, 8, 9, 1, 5, 4, 6, 7, 3. And we really just put this at the 2 at the end. 2, 5, 4, 6, 7, 5, 4, 6, 3, 7, 3. Two, eight, nine, one. Two, eight, nine, one. Two, eight, nine, do one. No, shoot. Okay, might just brute force this. And not use efficient data structures. Oh, hey Joshua, welcome into chat. I'm confusing myself using a deck. Okay, wait a second. No, see, that's the wrong stuff at the front. Destination 7. Then Thank you. we pick up 891, then we have 546732. 546732. Then we drain until we have 546. Put those towards the end. Then we get the 3-2. But then we need to put the 7 Yeah, this isn't gonna work. Or this is too confusing for me. Okay, let's try. My issue with that I was thinking of, okay. I was thinking of doing something along the lines of this, having a map, but the problem is that it's still O of N to update the map with the correct indices. So I got confused. And I have some friends who I think have kind of been brute forcing this. Maybe they're doing it smart, in a smart way. But I don't know. Oh, I have an idea. What if I make the space in between each one of these just massive? I don't think that works. Well, okay, let me just implement this code and then we can, without optimization, and see what happens. And then I can figure out maybe how to optimize. So current is this guy. Let's do that. Make sure to grab this as well. Zero to eight. Help if I remember that Python is in fact zero indexed. Let's see, where's the test? 389. Okay, what are the rules? If I just make this ever increasing, then it might just work. So like if I just say, So then I'll put it at the very end. Then I take the next three. Wow, that's impressive. Somebody solved it on my leaderboard. I'm here sitting here not knowing what the heck's going on. Okay, so okay, so I know where to put it. Oh, wait. Hold on. It's always a swap, right? This 3, 8, 9, 1 always effectively. Well, no, because it wraps around. Goes to 4. Label to index 4. How can I do this in O(1)? How am I supposed to do this? Let's see. Yeah, so what I'm doing right now is I'm kind of drawing out some of the things that, like, I'm drawing circles. I guess I should share this. Give me a second. I mean, more accurately, it's these three. Put those there. What is the destination supposed to be on this one? Seven. So those need to go there. So my thought is I can be cute with indexing. I think I wrote this wrong. So you get from here to here. You pick up 8, 9, 1 again. You put them after the 7. So how do we get from here to here? What's the rule for figuring out what the next current one is? If I was using this indexing scheme, see the problem is this three is now wrong. And I can't just go update everything or else that's going to be O of N. So yeah, so this is the challenge. Seems kind of ridiculous. How is this supposed to work? How am I supposed to do this move in O of 1? Shoot, what did I do? Oh, there we go. I have no idea. What am I supposed to do? How am I going to implement this in all one time? Yeah, so hey Josh, well, welcome back. I think I understand what needs to be O1. Basically this move, right? Like I guess I don't this move here. Was just thinking of trying to do some fancy index stuff. I did have a very bad thought, though. So my move function is basically just move the next three elements from the this from the thing that I'm looking at to after the source. So it's like this guy here as well. And this is gonna be still 90. Wait, and then this is. So what if I ever have to insert here? Does that work? Really, it's 3, 2, 8, 9, 1. Seven. To start off as a linked list, turn it into a tree. Then how do we do the next operation? We find the element of the tree, and then 891. We traverse that linked list, or potential. Oh, how do we know that this is cool? What if? And then what do I do with that? I guess I just, this isn't quite right. That doesn't seem right. I guess it's effectively just, oh, damn it. I see. And then effectively this guy goes back up here. That's always guaranteed to be the current, and then we can just do that. Okay. This is when I need to not be using Python. I see. Oh, thanks for the hint. Okay, so yeah, I think this is just a linked list, effectively. It's still kind of O of N to find the next, where to insert, but like it's fast once you do. Is oh, I see. Well, yeah, okay, I got it. This isn't gonna work. Well, I'll just leave. What do you mean invalid syntax when I have invalid syntax? Oh, that's wrong. It would help if I was indexing into the right thing. Two. Okay. And then we just update. So to do this, we have to update this pointer. So 3 has to point to 2. Oh, that's not good. Oh, I'm just bad at this. Okay, let's just print these out. So L of 3 down is 0.2. Thank you. Okay, that's not quite right. Oh, no, no, it's not. Okay, so 3, 8, 9, 1 goes to 2. So when we remove the next one, so current needs to be equal to 4 down. Okay, so that's not disputable. Three points to this now. Then, oh, this is where we need to calculate destination. So we skip over to this one. Yeah, that's good. And then shoot, did. Oh, man. I'm so such a moron. Oh my gosh. Oh, frick. No idea if this is right. So what's a label? Don't the labels stay the frickin' same? Okay, does anybody in chat know that how do these labels work? Like, I thought that the prize is like the labels on the cups stay the same. Oh, I see. So you just have to find the two that are immediately clockwise. I see. So it's at the end. I thought this was at the beginning. And I was really confused because that's like obviously trivial. Okay, so that's not it. Oh, I'm retarded. I was running it on the test input. Oh my gosh. Wow, I am so stupid. Guys, did you see that? That was impressive. That was impressively bad. I was wondering why it wasn't working. It's because I wasn't submitting using the right... I wasn't running it on the right input, guys. That's really kind of sad. That is quite sad. Okay, well, thank you for the occasional hint here. That did help. So Colin solved first. He's like actually good at this. He solved, he was 458. Easton, I don't know what he got, but he solved before me a couple minutes ago. But I do think that I will manage to eke out a couple of points on him tonight. Oh wait, no, that's last night. Shoot. 2 points. See, I didn't even look at the right leaderboard. Adam beat me again. Pathetic. Okay. Well, that was kind of a disaster. Let's get rid of some unnecessary debug statements. Okay, so this didn't work. Okay. Well, thank you for the hint. It's kind of pathetic that I didn't see that earlier. But, I don't know, kind of used to, should be used to that at this point. Okay, what else do I not need? Basically any data structures. Data structures are just bad for this problem. They're just too slow. There we go. Honestly though, I didn't really understand what was going on, to be perfectly honest. I really didn't. Like, I kind of, like, I had no idea how you're supposed to, yeah, you know, because I tried, trying a queue, because it's effectively a queue problem. And I was hoping that, like, maybe that would be fast enough. And then at that point, I had no idea what to do. And I just don't ever think about linked lists anymore. I haven't thought about linked lists since, you know, I was actually doing linked lists in classes. So yeah, probably if I had thought about it longer, maybe I would have done better, but I have no idea if I would have actually gotten it. Yeah, I would agree. This is one of my favorite ones as well. Like, you actually had to, like, do something novel and not just like throw it at a library or type out Chinese remainder theorem really fast. Yeah, I mean, I agree. This was at least an enjoyable problem despite how it, you know, actually went. Yeah, I'd say I did like this problem. It was pretty good. Like, mainly it was just me, which is like not seeing the key insight, which I prefer those problems where, or like not getting, because the other ones I feel like are more trivia, right? Like when the insight is trivia, then I'm like, ah, this is kind of lame, you know? Like if it's, hey Easton, how's it going, this was definitely like, you know, with the Chinese remainder theorem on day 13, you know, that was really just trivia. Do you remember Chinese remainder theorem from a math class that you've taken? Hey, Easton, I saw your message as well. I did use a dictionary. I'll show you in a minute. I did like that this was, yeah, that you had to do something novel. Yeah, so Easton, this is a data structure I used. Effectively a circular linked list, but you know, in Python and no pointers, so this is what I did. Yeah, so Joshua, I actually thought, like, I was trying to think about a data structure where, you know, you have O of 1 insert, and that's why I attempted a queue first. But I wasn't thinking about O of 1 lookup, and I wasn't quite sure how to even achieve that, which is why I was very confused for a long time. So yeah, this is, I don't know, I feel like this is really gross. I would have much preferred having pointers today, and a good old node struct. Oh, I guess, yeah, mine is more of a, like, I don't know, it's not really a list, but it's effectively a list. I used a dictionary because I was being lazy. Interesting. So pointers are actually slower. Huh. I guess it's just because of locality, right? Yeah. Twice as much data. That's probably what it is. Yeah, so I did an int dict as well because I didn't want to figure out indices. But I think that you can just use, now that I'm thinking about it, you can just use the indices. That works too. Okay. Should I just convert to using a list? Because this should totally work as well. For C in cups, L dot append. Oh wait, no, L is just cups 1 plus cups 0. Oh. Wait. No, that's not right. That's totally not right. Nah, dictionary. Dictionary is pretty easy here. I think that this is the way to go. Like, it's slower. But I'd rather, what's the proper way of doing this? I guess still this might work. No. Effectively, we need a pointer from the current index to the index of the next one. Oh, I see. So okay. So the issue, so my dictionary is cup I label to cup label. So it's not index to index. Does that affect things? I have a feeling it does. Okay, what's the proper way of doing this? Oh, I see. Maybe just do this. This is kind of gross. I want to do while loop, you know? But it doesn't exist in Python. This is literally the one use case where a do while loop is what I want, you know? Okay, yeah, I don't know. Definitely disappointing with how it went, but I did like this. This was kind of fun. And I was pretty happy with how part one went. You know, I did it I did it pretty fast. Input parsing, let's just talk about input parsing. Nothing to write home about. All I'm doing is converting all of the each of the individual digits to numbers. That's what this is doing, and I'm putting it in the cups variable because the input of this one is where's the input? It's just like a number. And these specify like the cup IDs, the initial cup IDs, the first 9. So 1, 5, 6, 7, 9, 4, 8, 2, 3. So yeah, this is going character wise and converting each to integers. And then I'm calculating the min and the max, which I should probably do in here instead of in here, because that kind of bit me. No, I think let's just do it out here and then like name them good. Min cup max cup. Max cup, min cup, max cup. And then down here, what we'll do is we'll do max cup as well. I guess it's always one, right? Let's just do that just for sake of generality though. So yeah, that's all that the input parsing does. It's pretty basic. Current. So for part one, what I did was, I think, pretty good. It was fast, which is, well, fast-ish. It wasn't fast enough, but it was fast-ish compared to what I normally end up doing. So basically the concept is I always keep the current one in the first element of the list, and then I put everything else. That means that the things that get picked up are always going to be the next 3 elements, and then the rest are just cups onward. And the key insight here is with this problem, all you care about is basically these first 4 numbers, or first 5, really. You could say that. And then here, so D equals current minus. A cup label. So this is a stupid way of doing the wraparound. I don't know if there's any better way of doing this. I'm sure there is. So we'll name that destination, and then the destination can't be one of the ones that was picked. This comes in real handy for the next part because, well, linked lists. That would be quite nasty. So the next thing here is, this is very inefficient, but it worked for part one because, well, hitters is 100, so it's fine. Anything's fast when there's only 100, basically. Okay, not factorial, not exponential. But anything remotely polynomial is going to be fast enough, probably. So basically what this does is it goes and it finds and then it finds the destination index, and then it splits the cups list at that index, and then inserts the picked element, picked part of the list in between, and then appends current to the end. This is so the element after current is the one that gets chosen as the current on the next round. And then this is just a really dumb way of concatenating everything together. So this is just a really dumb way of doing of converting the number to a string. And oh, I guess actually, hold on. Let's see. Maybe I can update this. So okay, so yeah, I think what I'll do is I'll save this in a minute, and then I'll go back and fix it using the part 2 code. And then let's do one onward. It's important to exclude the one. I lost a minute on that. Okay, let's move on to part two. Part two is where things are interesting. Let's see. Let's just change up a couple of things. Let's edit that. So for part two, basically we have to simulate this thing, which I showed it's, we have to do this simulation, but fast. And clearly, so the 10 million, that's a lot. That's a lot of iterations, and there's, and n is huge. The number of things that we would have to look through is massive. So let's not do that. A naive implementation of this will take ages, definitely on the order of hours, probably days, tens of hours or days. So we have to be smart, which is hard for me, but the key insight is that, let me actually see if I can open this. So the insight is that, this is the assist that I got from Twitch chat, so thank you, Joshua. So the insight for part two is that effectively this process of taking elements and moving them to somewhere else has to be fast. In fact, it has to be precisely O of one, constant time. There's two things here though. The first thing is, extracting out elements. The second thing is finding another element and inserting at that element. So basically, we have three different operations here. For each iteration that needs to be constant time. One, first, removing the three elements to the right of the current element. So that's basically, if this is our current element, it's removing these three here, like getting rid of those three. And basically moving this two so it's next to the three. The next thing is finding the destination. That's the second challenge. The third challenge is inserting an element. To the right of the destination. So these are the three things that matter. And the key insight is that this is actually a place where linked lists actually work. Or not really linked lists, but linked list type things work. Basically, what ends up happening is that it's a linked list that you can index into at any point. So I don't know what that would be called. Is there a name for this data structure? So the issue that I had is that at first, so a deck, a double-ended queue. This didn't work. So I at first attempted to implement all of this using a deck. It doesn't work that way. Yeah, so I guess this is Joshua and Chad is mentioning this is basically an implicitly linked list. I guess that's a good way of describing it. Anyway, this deck idea was kind of because it solves part one and part three easily. Inserting and removing are trivial from they're O of one on at the front or the back of once the destination is found. It solves, it can do both one and two in O of one time. However, this doesn't work. Oh my gosh, I can't spell. Because two is still O of N, which isn't good enough. Okay, so the step from this then is you can't use a deck. Basically, you can't use any data structure that exists in a standard library. So there's actually multiple key insights. The first key insight is this. The second key insight the three above properties can be achieved via a linked list if you can find the if you can implement a way to find the destination element constant time. So this second bit here is key. If you, this can be accomplished if you have a way to find the node where a given label is. Have a label to node. Something like this. So this is the key. You need a label to node idea. And what I did is I did it this implicitly. Of a dictionary that allows me to accomplish the same thing without a explicit extra mapping. So how does this work in practice? Basically, I have a mapping, an L mapping. This is my linked list effectively. Which is a dictionary of label to label. So at the beginning, the linked list is just the first element points to the second element points to the third element, etc. And so what I've done here is initialize the linked list with the initial values in the cups array. So, you know, cups 0 will point to cups 1, and I'm using the cup IDs. I'm not using indices. I'm just doing 0 points. So, you know, in our case, the input was what? Was 1567. So initially it'll be that it has 1 pointed to 5, 5 pointed to 6, 6 pointed to 7. So yeah, initialize the linked list, then we wrap around. Okay. So this isn't a real linked list. It's kind of a implicit linked list because it's just basically indexing. It's just like indexing as a dictionary back onto itself, but it works. It's the same concept as a linked list. And basically, this is where we do the lookup in O of one time. Because each node of the linked list is in the dictionary, we can actually index find the element within by just looking it up. I think this is the real key. So this is like the fact that you can go and just find things by their ID within your dictionary. This is essential. Here we get the element that the current points to. So that's whenever you see linked list indexing, it's just getting the next thing from the linked list, the thing after current, basically. So this is the start of everything that's being picked. And then we, for three steps. So basically we're gonna go three steps from here and we're gonna get the we don't care about like the second down or the third down or the fourth down. We only care about the third down and the fourth down. Let me add a comment here. This is pretty confusing, I think. So here, let's say our linked list looks like this. One points to five, points to nine, points to, let's just say six. Six, one, five, six, seven, nine. Seven, nine. Four, eight. And then two, three. If current is five, linked list of current going to give six, then we iterate three steps. So basically we want the thing that is four away from five. So one, two, three, four steps. Four steps. And basically this four down, this is what we're gonna set five's pointer to by bypassing them with a pointer change. So I'm going to use the same linked list throughout this explanation here. But basically, three down is going to be set to nine. Basically, that's so that we can make sure that that points to the correct thing at the very end, so we don't get an infinite loop and we don't get some issue where we're dangling pointers and we don't have anywhere to go. Again, this is implicit because, you know, these are just all in the dictionary. It's just dictionary lookups. So four down, three down. Yeah, basically we just compute who. Oh, wait, we can make this even simpler. Four down equals linked list. So this is going to be start picked, I guess. Picked three is going to be picked two, and then first not picked equals linked list of picked three. Yeah, I think that'll work. And then here we can do this. And then four down turns into first not picked. Picked one. And then picked three. And then this one goes to first not picked. Okay, so this nastiness is now gone. And okay, so that's it. Let's see here. Let's see if I can maybe kind of ASCII art this. We're doing a bypass. So this bypasses the everything and goes to the next thing in the list. Then then find the destination. So the next thing is we need to find the element that's after the destination, and that's this after destination here. And then destination would be 4 in this case, right? So it's just 5 minus 1, which is 4. And it's not less than 1, and it's also not in the picked set. So that will be our destination. Thus, the after destination will be 8. And then effectively what we are going to do here is do a list insertion. So we're going to take the destination and point it at the 6, and then we're going to take the 9 and point it at whatever the destination is pointing to. So we have to save this off so that we can do that. And honestly, let's see, can we just do thus, let's see, let's actually, let me just see if I can just, do this. I think this works. We need to splice in the picked element back into the list right after the destination. And so that's what we're doing. The first step is to point the end of the picked list at the node that the destination points to. And that's what this is doing. Let's ask ER this again. Basically, this will now point at no longer 4, but it'll point at 8. And then the next step in splicing in the list is to point 4 at, is to point the destination at the beginning of the picked list. And once we've done this, then this is going to get really messy. Basically, this 4 no longer points here. It's going to point all the way back here, and then it's going to point up, and then it'll point through this, and then up here. Okay. So this is kind of a little bit convoluted, but I think it's pretty decent to look at. Well, this isn't that decent. It explains what's going on. If we unravel this, then we get 1 goes to 5, goes to 4, goes to 6, goes to 7, goes to 9, goes to 8, goes to 2, goes to 3. Finally, all we do is set the new current node to the node that is directly to the right of the current node. It is guaranteed that this will be the first node that wasn't spliced out. Right, so at the end of the day, 5 is always going to be pointing at the first not found, this one here. Okay, I think that's the explanation here. It's a bit long-winded. Thank you for the follow, James. Didn't see you in here. Appreciate it. Okay, let's just go ahead and end it here. Thank you all for watching. If you're on YouTube, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. And come over and follow me on Twitch, where I'm streaming this every single night of Advent. We're only 2 more days to go, which is kind of sad. It's been a ton of fun. There have been a lot of interesting problems, and then a lot of problems that were really annoying, and then some that I absolutely hated. But overall, it's been pretty great. And if you want to join the fun and join our chat room, I cut out a lot of stuff from the VODs on YouTube, but if you come over to Twitch, then you can watch it live, or you can come over and watch the previous recordings as well. So yeah, join us for the last 2 days of Advent of Code, and I will see you all tomorrow for day 24.